Hello, good morning to everyone, new all of the energetic student of the 7th class. Today we are going to start our second chapter, fraction and decimals. Okay, first we are going to start second question. We will do first chapter later. Okay, so first chapter, second chapter is fraction and decimals. Everyone are familiar with all of these terms, okay? What is proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction, equivalent fraction, like and unlike fraction. In 6th class, we have already studied about it, okay? Those who did not finish this chapter of the 6th class fraction, you can watch my video again, okay? It is very important. Again, I am telling you in a brief introduction of what is proper fraction. Proper fraction mean, dear, when numerator is less than denominator. Suppose 2 by 5, 3 upon 6, 7 upon 9. When numerator, it is denominator. When numerator is less than denominator. Either you can say that proper fraction is always represent a part of whole. Okay, part of whole means if it is a bread, okay, and you want to take it, you can divide in 4 equal parts, so one part, it is a proper fraction. Next is improper fraction means, dear, when numerator is greater than denominator. Suppose opposite of this one, 5 upon 2, so numerator is greater, 6 upon 3, 9 upon 7, all these are the improper fraction. Okay, improper fraction mean a whole and its part. Okay, next is mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is combination of whole and proper fraction. Suppose like this one, 2 and 3 upon 5. Okay, so 5 2 are 10, 10 plus 3 13 divided by 5, 4 upon 7. So these are mixed fraction. Next is equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction means equal fraction. Suppose it is 4 upon 5. The equivalent fraction, how many are? There are infinite, countless equivalent fraction of any fraction. Everyone know, we have discussed two property of equivalent fraction. We can multiply numerator and denominator by same number. Suppose we are multiplying 2, 2. What it become? 8 by 10. It means 4 by 5 and 8 by 10 are equivalent a fraction. 4 upon 5. You can multiply 10. But in denominator also 10. Number should be same. 40 upon 50. Next is like fraction. What is? Like fraction means, dear, if denominator are same of two fraction, they are like a fraction. Like fraction, 4 upon 5 and 2 upon 5. Denominator is same. It means they are like fraction. And if it is like fraction, you can compare easily. Which one is greater? 4 upon 5 and 2 upon 5. If denominator is same, so it means 4 upon 5 is greater. And unlike fraction means when the denominator are not same. 2 upon 8 and 9 upon 7. Here, denominator is not a same. Can you tell me which one is greater or smaller? It is very difficult to say directly which one is greater, which one is lesser. So, we will first make them convert in like fractions. Okay? So, these are the basics of the fraction. Now, we are going to start our exercise 2.1. Okay? So now, everyone open your books. So first question of 2.1 exercise. Solve them. 2.1. And always one thing is remember. What is meaning of 5, dear? 5. 5 mean? Can you write 5 equal to 5 by 1? Yes. 5 divided by 1. 5 divided by 1, again we get 5. So we can write any number. If it is 2, so 2 we can write 2 upon 1. Understand why? Because 2 we can multiply 1 and divide by also 1. Okay. It is 2. Understand it? So now we will solve it. So first is 2 minus solid 2 minus 3 upon 5. 2 minus 3 upon 5 solid. So how will we solve it? Always one thing is remember. So first you can write 2 upon 5 minus 3 upon 5. 2 fraction. 2 fractions. How can we add and subtract? It is very important step. Note down it. So first step. 2 fraction, how can we add and subtract? So first step is always taking LCM of denominator. It is denominator 1 and 5. So first step what is taking LCM of denominator? What? So LCM, so we write LCM of 1 and 5 is how much? LCM is 1 and 5, how much? Any number which can divide 1 and 5? No. So if there is no number which can divide both number, you can direct multiply. So 1 into 5, 5. So 2 upon 1 minus 3 upon 5. What is LCM? LCM is 5. LCM is 5. Understand it? So it's like this one. 1, 5, 1, 5, 1. So what is LCM? So 5 into 1 into 1. So what is LCM? 5 is LCM. So what we will do? So first step you already finished. What is LCM? LCM is 5. Next is what we will do? Divide the LCM by denominator. Next. Divide the LCM by denominator. I am writing in short form, okay? By denominator. And what we get? And what we get? Multiply by numerator. There is only 2 steps to add or subtract the LCM. So look at what is divide the LCM. LCM is 5 by denominator. So 5 divided by 1. 5 divided by 1. 5. What we get? 5. What we get? Multiply it by numerator. So what we get? 5. 5 multiply numerator 5 into 2. Now again minus sign. Again same step. LCM is divided by. So LCM is 5 divided by denominator. 5 divided by 5. 1. And what we get? 1 is multiplied by numerator. It is your 2 steps to solve the to add fraction. Okay, if you understand it is very simple. You can do all of that, all question yourself. Understand it? So note down it. These 2 steps very important. So now what we will do next is look at 5 into 2 10 minus 1 into 3 3 divide by 5. And everyone know when we add or subtract, 1, 10 is positive, it is negative. Different sign. 1 is positive, 1 is negative. They are different sign, and different sign always we will subtract. So 10 minus 3, 7. And put the sign greater number. Greater is 10. 10 is positive, so 7 also positive. So 7 upon 5. 7 upon 5. It is your answer. And you can write it in mixed fraction also. Mixed fraction. 7 divided by 5. Understand? 5 ones are 5 divided by 2. So what is 1 upon 2 upon 5. Okay. So always remember how do we write in mixed fraction? It is 1. Here is quotient. Here is remainder and divide by dividend. Divide. Okay. So it is quotient is 1. Remainder 2 and it is. Understand? So it is formula you can do. In 7th class we have already finished it. Okay. Now look at one more part. 5th part of 1st question. 2nd, 3rd, 4th you will do yourself. Okay. Next. So 5th part, look at 7 upon 10 plus 2 upon 5 plus 3 upon 2. So first step, always remember, whenever we want to add or subtract the fraction, what is taking LCM of it? Denominator. So LCM you can find like this one 10, 5, 2. If you don't know how to take LCM, look at. We will write all three number and we will divide, we will write a prime number, which can divide at least one number. Prime number means a number which have only two factor, one and itself. First prime number 2, 3, 5, 7. 9 is prime number? No, because 9 can be divided by 1 also, 3 also, 9. 7, 11, 13, these are prime number. There are many prime. So first prime number is always 2. Yes, can we divide? Always remember, we will take a right, we will divide the whole numbers. Oh, we will divide these number by a prime number which can divide at least 1. Okay, so 2 is divided, 2 also is 1 number we need, and 10 also, 2, 5 is 10, and if 2 is not dividing 5, we will write as it is, okay, same as it is, 2, 1 is 1, now again, we can divide 5, 1, 1, 1, so now what is LCM, 2 into 5, 10, 10 into 1, 10, 10, 10, so what is LCM, so you can write, LCM of 10, 5 and 2 is how much? 2 into 5, 10. Okay. If you know, you can write direct also. Okay. Understand it? So look at now. 7 by 10 plus 2 by 5 plus 3 by 2 and LCM is 10. Next step. What is? I already told you. Divide the LCM. What is LCM? 10 by denominator. What is denominator? 10. 10 divided by 10. 1. And what we get? What we get? 1 is multiplied by numerator. 1 into 7 plus. Understand? Next. 10 LCM divided by denominator. 5. What we get? 2. And what we get? 2 into 2. Again, 10 divided by 2. 5. 5 multiplied by 3. It is very simple. Only 2 steps. You have to remember. Understand dear? Now look at. 1 into 7. 7. Plus 2 into 2. Board mass formula we will have. Bracket of division. Okay. Multiply, addition and subtraction. 1 into 7, 7. 2 into 2, 4. 5 into 3, 15. Divide by 10. Next is 7 plus 4, 11. 11 plus 15, 26. Divide by 10. Write in mixed fraction yourself. 10 to the 20. How much remainder? 6 divide by 10. So it is your answer. of the fifth part. Understand it, dear? Rest of the do part also you will do yourself. Understand it? Yes? Again, dekho. How will we solve the mixed fraction? 10 into 2, 20. 20 plus 6. 20 plus 6, 26 divided by 10. Understand? How to open mixed fractions? 4, 7 divided by 9. So how will you open? 9 into 4. 9 into 4, 36. 36 plus 7, 43 divided by 9. Like this one, we will solve it. Okay? Otherwise, you can write like this one. 9 into 4 plus 7 divided by 9. Understand it? Otherwise, you can write direct also. Okay? We already discussed in 7th class. Okay? Next is question number 2. Second question, first part, arrange the following in descending order. In descending order. In descending order, 2 upon 9, 2 upon 3, and next is 18 by 20. We have to arrange in descending order. In which? Descending order. Descending order. So if I write only numbers 6, 7 and 12, write in descending order, you write sir 12, 7, 6. It is very simple. But if I write in fraction, suppose 2 upon 5, 4 upon 5, 3 upon 5, write in descending. We observe that here is denominator is same. Denominator is same. So first greater 4 upon 5. 3 upon 5 and 2 upon 5. So, it is descending order. But, one thing we observe that here is denominator are different. So, if denominator are different, what we will do? So, if denominator are different here, so first we will make different, we will make denominator are same. And denominator same, how can we make? By equivalent fraction. So, and so what we will do? Always first find LCM of 9, 3 and 21 is. So, we will find LCM. Okay. What is LCM? Look at 9, 3, 21. What I told you? Divide by a prime number. Which can divide at least one number? Yes, 2 is not dividing none of them. So we will divide by 3. 3, 3 is a 3, 1 is a 3, 7. Any number, again divide by 3. 3, 1 is a 1 as it is, 7 as it is. Now again, 7, 1, 1, 1. Now, 7 into 3, 21. 21 into 3, 63. Why we are finding LCM here? So it means what is LCM of its come? 63. So now we will make denominator of every fraction is 63. Okay, so we will write 2 upon 9. What I am telling you, what number you will multiply? What is denominator we want to make? 63. So what number you multiply by 9, then it becomes 63. 7. 9 into 7, 63. Same. And we know in equivalent fraction here, always multiply and divide by same numbers. So here also we will divide by 7. So 14 upon this one. It means 2 by 9 equal to 14 upon 63. Same as it is. 2 upon 3. What 2? What is denominator we need? 63. So what number you multiply by 63? What number? You will multiply 6 by a number by 3. It can we will get 63. If you don't know, what we will do? 63 divided by 3. 3 to the 6, 3, 1 the 3. So what is? So 3 into 21, 63. Understand? Because 63 divided by 3, what we get? 21. So again here 21. So what is come? 42. Understand it? Next is here 8 upon 21. We need in denominator 63. What number you multiply by? By 3. 24 upon 63. Understand? Now we observe that all of them 63. So we will write descending order of 14 upon 63, 42 by 63 and 24 by 63 is how much? So descending means first we will write greater. Which one greater? 42 upon 63 greater than 24 by 63. 14 by 63. 42 by 63 mean 2 upon 3. 24 by 63 mean 8 by 21 greater. And then last is 2 by 9. So look at, don't say sir it is bigger. Only looking on the look, you will observe the question and you will say that it is bigger. No, 2 by, it is bigger than all of them, 2 upon 3. Understand it? So how will we arrange it? Always remember, first we will find if denominator are not same, we will make denominator are same. And denominator same how? By taking LCM and make the all of the denominator is same as the LCM. Understand? It is your answer. It. Okay? Only this much, first question and second question you will do today. Okay? It's enough. Okay? So thank you everyone and I hope you are, everyone is well and healthy and please start your preparation. Okay, if any problem, you can ask me anytime. Thank you everyone. Have a good day.